Hey everyone, welcome back to Chipstock Investor. Today we are going to interrupt our regular scheduled programming to talk about a very important announcement that has come out. Up until this point, it was all just rumors and hopefulness, maybe, that Synopsys would be acquiring ANSYS. But now we have had that press release that, yes, in fact, Synopsys has made their intentions known and they intend to acquire ANSYS. Nick, you can give us some of the details.
Yeah, let's begin with your semiconductor industry flowchart. And as we often show when we talk about EDA, electronic design automation, think of this as AutoCAD for chips, for semiconductors in particular. It is absolutely foundational to the semiconductor industry. It's foundational to chip design and chip making as software. The end product at the end of the chip industry flow funnels back into the start of the process again to power the next generation of computing hardware development. So Synopsys and Cadence Design Systems, Synopsys ticker symbol SNPS, Cadence Design Systems, CDNS, are the two leaders. And so Synopsys saying that it is merging with ANSYS, which is used to virtually test and simulate how a product will behave in the real world before it's actually made, is a big deal. $35 billion being offered in cash and stock. This is as of December 21st, before the rumor mill got fired up for ANSYS, $35 billion. So this instantly will slide in as one of the largest tech merger and acquisition deals ever. Broadcom just bought VMware for $70 billion last year. Dell acquired EMC back in 2016 for $67 billion. IBM bought Red Hat for $34 billion in 2019. Cisco and Splunk, which is still pending at roughly $28 billion. So you can get the gist here. $35 billion for ANSYS. This is a top five largest ever tech deal, and perhaps one of the least known tech enterprise merger among most people. Synopsys and ANSYS, not exactly household names, especially among the non-tech investing community.
Let's break down how this $35 billion valuation came about. As of market open January 17th, the total value for ANSYS is actually $32.4 billion, given that this is a variable price deal because of the stock element. ANSYS shareholders will receive $197 per share, which equals to $17.2 billion based on 87.38 million shares of ANSYS outstanding as of September 30th, which was the last earnings updates in 2023. So ANSYS holders will receive that $197 per share, plus they will receive 0.345 shares of Synopsys for every share of ANSYS, which is worth about $15.4 billion, which is based on that stock price for Synopsys of $510 on January 16th, and that almost 87.4 million shares of ANSYS outstanding. Gives us a grand total of about $32.4 billion worth in acquisition cost. So that value will change daily based on the stock prices of both Synopsys and ANSYS. And we do expect a ton of regulatory scrutiny with this merger, similar to what we saw with Broadcom and VMware. And if approved, it won't happen likely until 2025. We expect a special scrutiny within the European Union and China.
So stay tuned for that. In the meantime, let's talk about why this deal is being proposed in the first place. So if you are familiar with these two software companies, you're probably thinking ANSYS is not an EDA company. It does not do electronic design automation. Of course, physics simulation and related capabilities are important for semiconductor companies. You definitely want to test what your chip is going to do before you spend all the money to manufacture it. Interestingly, ANSYS's high-tech and semiconductor customers only make up about a low to mid 30% of total revenue. You can see that in the chart here that ANSYS provided at their last report in November 2023. So what's the rationale for this exactly? Because most of ANSYS's customers are non-tech businesses. You can see lots of companies in aerospace and in manufacturing automotive customers. Here's a partial quote from the press release between Synopsys and ANSYS that explains why the merger. All ANSYS customers, including those outside of the semiconductor industry, can benefit from access to a comprehensive portfolio of products and technologies. We'll insert our words here. That means Synopsys electronic design automation software, chip patents, and computing system design and test software. That will drive innovation. So put simply, semiconductors are going into literally everything these days. Use cases are only getting more complex. So all companies need to be IT companies. So Synopsys plus ANSYS hopes that they can help more customers accomplish that necessity, converging chips with existing electromechanical systems that are out there already. This is very much, you could say, an AI-driven merger. And we'll just say AI, whenever you see that, just read far more complicated software-defined systems that non-tech businesses really don't have the know-how to handle. And yet business demand and consumer demands are asking for more stuff with these complicated software-enabled, software-powered systems in them. So Synopsys plus ANSYS can help meet that need. That's why Synopsys semiconductor EDA business merging with ANSYS, largely a non-tech software simulation engine.
Combined, the two businesses will have a total addressable market of $28 billion, growing at a CAGR of 11%, and that's their estimate through 2028. Is this a good deal for shareholders of both ANSYS and Synopsys? For ANSYS, this question is a little bit easier because they're the ones getting acquired in this transaction. And we think for ANSYS shareholders, this is a very good deal. The company has really struggled with consistency the last few years, and it's now being cashed out at a significant premium, around 45 times free cash flow and nearly 60 times earnings per share as of this recording. What about Synopsys, Nick?
So it's a bit more complicated for Synopsys shareholders. They are going to be the majority owners of the new entity. Should Synopsys and ANSYS combine, they'll be about 85, 86% total ownership of the new business entity. And here's why we think this is going to be a bit more murky for existing Synopsys shareholders. If we take the two business entities right now and assume that they're all together, this marriage has been tied up and they're operating now together. Combined, trailing 12-month revenue is about $8 billion. That's $5.84 billion from Synopsys over the last 12 months and about $2.16 billion from ANSYS. Combined free cash flow is about $2.14 billion. So that's about $1.51 billion in free cash flow from Synopsys over the last 12 months and about $632 million from ANSYS. However, as of right now, as of our recording here, the two companies combined have a market cap of at least $105 billion and growing from there if the deal goes through, owing to the fact that ANSYS's market cap right now is going to go from roughly $30 billion to $35 billion because of some uncertainty about the deal going through. There's a bit of a discount in ANSYS's current market cap and the ultimate buyout price of $35 billion. Let's just say right at the moment, at least $105 billion market cap, the two companies. That's a steep price for a combined entity that's only generating about $2.2 billion in free cash flow. I think you get the picture here. It's on a combined basis, about 50x trailing 12-month free cash flow. Now, things get a little bit murkier because there's going to be some new debt involved with funding this deal, right, Kasey?
Yes, there will be plenty of debt to be paid down. As of last quarter, Synopsys had almost $1.6 billion in cash and short-term investments and $18 million in debt, so very, very little. ANSYS had $754 million in cash and short-term investments with $639 million in debt. But Synopsys has $16 billion in new debt financing to fund this cash payout to ANSYS shareholders. So this debt paydown will be key the first 2 years, at least through 2027, and stock repurchases will be suspended likely until 2026 at least.
Yeah, it's going to be messy. So we've actually pointed this out in past videos on Synopsys that they actually had far more net cash in short-term investments than Cadence Design Systems, their biggest peer in EDA software. And we pointed this out, that it's likely because Synopsys was getting ready for a bigger acquisition. This is a really big acquisition because obviously, like you just said, Kasey, they don't have enough cash to fund the cash portion of the purchase. So this is a long-term move by Synopsys management. This is not going to be a quick, immediate kick-in of profitable growth for the business. Like you just pointed out, Kasey, shareholders are going to have to wait until at least 2026, if not 2027, until that debt, that new $16 billion in new debt financing gets paid back down to a healthy level, and until management can fire up the share repurchase program again. So if the deal goes through in 2025, we think there's going to be this bridge of a year to two where the market keeps a lid on Synopsys stock post-acquisition of ANSYS. But the ultra long-term rationale, I think, does make sense because, again, as we've mentioned in past videos, a key tenet to our investment thesis, our long-term investment thesis in Synopsys, is they have a lot of ability to ratchet up their operating profit margins in the coming years. And it looks like that remains the goal of management, even with ANSYS getting added into the mix.
So currently, combined adjusted operating margins of 37% right now, but could exceed 40% by 2027. The long-term target is mid-40% range, so that's a positive. But there will be an elevated risk of the stock price having a cap on it until this merger is complete and they reach those long-term goals, in our opinion. Ultimately, this is a monster bet on AI and advanced software-driven devices proliferating through all corners of the economy in the coming decade.
Yeah, let's go back to the semiconductor industry flow chart just one more time to show just how important EDA software is. It's foundational. It's a critical choke point in the semiconductor industry flow. And Synopsys is making this big bet to deepen its roots in the industry and to increase its importance to AI. And again, when we say AI, we're not talking about the buzzy gen AI that NVIDIA is helping fuel in the data center. We're talking about the proliferation of chips and advanced software systems throughout every corner of the economy. That will happen because of this EDA segment in the semiconductor industry flow. So, Kasey, we have been dollar cost averaging into both Synopsys and Cadence Design Systems starting in 2022. We put a pause on both of those DCA plans at the very tail end of 2023. At this point, I think we're going to continue that pause, definitely on Synopsys. What do you think about Cadence, though? I know the viewers are probably definitely wondering about that one just as much as they are Synopsys.
Yeah, I think we'll have to reevaluate after earnings season with Cadence and see if we want to fire up our DCA plan again or if it's going to remain on hold. We've highlighted over the last year plus, one of the biggest differences between the top two EDA companies is that Synopsys has favored bigger acquisitions. Cadence instead has smaller tuck-in acquisitions and organic growth. There's unique risks with each strategy. So at this point, both our DCA plans have been on pause, and we are definitely putting the brakes on any investment into Synopsys at this point, given the elevated use of debt to acquire ANSYS for a high premium.
Yeah, that certainly doesn't mean we're going to sell our position in Synopsys. Again, just a pause on the DCA plan. We'll see what Cadence does, but just to illustrate their more slower pace of acquisitions to enter new markets, Synopsys is kind of making a cannonball move at this point. Cadence made more of a less earth-shattering acquisition last year when they made that purchase, or I guess at this point it was 2022, when they made that purchase of OpenEye Scientific to take their EDA platform and extend it into molecular design and simulation, life sciences industries, development of pharmaceuticals and biotech. That was a very, very small tuck-in acquisition that didn't blow up the balance sheet at all. In fact, it barely even registered as a blip. Synopsys is definitely willing to disrupt the balance sheet and go through these periods of a year or two or more to digest big acquisitions. They've done this in the past when they got into cybersecurity and software verification services in recent years. And now they're doing it again with a much, much bigger move for ANSYS. So I think that's our reason for the pause. It's not that we suddenly dislike Synopsys, but given this overhang of debt that's coming at some point, we think it warrants a pause because what was already a rich valuation now looks like an even richer valuation for a company that's going to have significant debt and interest payment obligations for a while. So we'll update you again on this after earnings and especially what we decide with Cadence. But that's what we're thinking for ourselves personally at this point.
All right. That is our quick update on this big news of Synopsys acquiring ANSYS. We still have Lam Research coming up in our videos. Make sure you hit the subscribe button if you have not already. And make sure you have notifications turned on. We always have updates on our community board. Hope you have a great day and we'll see you all soon at Chipstock Investor.